Right, so we're going to have a look at something called conditionals, and conditionals give the program you're writing a lot more interactivity because it can choose between certain conditions, hence the name conditionals. So to kind of explain how this works, let's put in an input statement, and we'll call it choice, and we'll say input. Do you like cheese? Okay, not quite sure why I've got this obsession with cheese, but there we go. So we've got a question that the user is going to answer. And let's just give them some more instructions. Type yes or no. Okay. So what we're going to do now is they are going to hopefully type either yes or no, and we will give them a different response depending on what they type. Okay, so the way we can write this is like this. If choice is equal to yes, then we can give them a print statement saying, so well done. You are a cheese legend. Okay. And then we need something if they don't say yes. So what we can do is we type else, colon, and then new line, and then never mind, try some more until you like it. Okay. Right, so what we have here is, I'll just explain how this works. So we're going to get an input from the user. It's either going to be yes or no, and it's going to be assigned to this variable called choice. Okay, and here this is our conditional. So we're saying if choice is equal to, and you'll notice that we've got two equal symbols, okay? And that does mean equal to in Python. A single equals sign means it's what's called an assignment. It assigns a value to a variable, okay? So we've got to use a double equal sign here. So if choice is yes, we'll get that printed. If choice is anything else, okay, they could even type in maybe, they'll get this print statement. Okay, so let's try it and see what happens. Okay, do we like cheese? Please type yes or no. Okay, so let's try our yes conditional. So yes, well done, you are a cheese legend. Great, and the program ends, so it's done what we wanted. And in program, it's always important to try the other version. So let's run it again, and this time we'll type in no. Never mind, try some more until you like it. Okay, good. Now, let's just run this again. And let's just type in, you see here, sometimes when people see a cursor right next to the last line, they put a space in. And if we type in yes, okay, it gives us the other answer. Okay, and the reason is we've typed space yes. Okay, now the conditional is only looking for yes, okay, not space yes, so it's still giving us the else conditional. So just a little handy hint here, when you're writing the string part of the input statement, if you put like a colon and then a space, if we now look at this, what it will do is automatically put that space in for us. So you see there, so the user hopefully will be slightly less confused when they do this, okay. Now the other issue is if they do type something else that maybe we want a different response to, we need more than two options. So we've only got if and else here. So what we could do is we can use something called elif, okay, which is like a kind of third option. So elif choice is equal to maybe, then colon print, I don't know, good on you, keep trying it. Okay. So we've now got a third option. So yes, maybe, or anything else. Okay, so let's just test that out. Do you like cheese? Yes or no? Maybe. Okay, good. So that's given us that third option. So we'd have to now actually change that to make more sense. Yes, maybe, or no. And let's run that. So the good thing here with conditionals is now we could have as many options as we like. So if we wanted another option, elif choice, okay, it doesn't really make much grammatical sense, but never mind, print nice cheese. Okay, this is descending into something that makes no sense whatsoever. Yes, okay, maybe, or whatever. Okay, so now we've got four choices, so let's run this. Okay, do you like cheese? Let's try the okay choice. Nice cheese, good. Okay, so we can have as many elifs as we like. Okay, we can just keep putting them in for more choices. So why don't you try writing a program where maybe it's like a music recommendation program. They could maybe type in a genre of music, and depending on that genre, it will give them a selection of artists they could potentially listen to. So give that a go and see how you get on.